You guys are having a great start to your week. So I've been kind of putting off this video just because I knew it would be pretty long, but I decided I need to film it now before I forget everything. So this video is going to be my experience on a Disney cruise in general, some tips and tricks that I recommend if you are going on a Disney cruise, and then also kind of go into my experience actually getting married on a Disney cruise and how I liked it. If you too are considering getting married on a cruise or a Disney cruise, three things. If you hear rain, it is pouring rain outside, which leads to my hair. My hair was done a lot better than this, but I ran from the car into the house and it just got destroyed, so I was like, oh well. And then third, I do have a horrible sunburn. I went to the Epcot Food and Wine Festival, and I didn't realize how, it was misleading. It seemed like it wasn't that sunny, but it was like humid and the sun, I don't know, it tricked me, and I did put it all over my face and everything, but then I forgot this. And so as you can see, I'm pretty burnt. So if you're wondering what that is, it gets worse. It's like all the way down here. Yeah. Another thing is, don't you guys love my sheep shirt? I got this at Target. It was a sweater that was on clearance. I got it for like 10 bucks and it's so cute. So run to Target and get a sheep shirt. So I have been on almost every cruise line. Like, I've been on Royal Caribbean, Carnival, Norwegian, Princess, pretty much all of the major ones that are in the US at least. And I would say like the Disney cruise blows them all away. And it's not just because I'm a Disney fan. Like, obviously there's perks of being a Disney fan, but honestly, if you're not a Disney fan, I think just the level of service that you experience on a Disney cruise is just like amazing. So, one thing, the only downside I'm gonna say just up front is, yes, Disney cruises cost a lot more than regular cruises, but you get what you pay for, to be honest with you. Like I said, I've been on all of them. I've been on like a 200 buck Carnival cruise. And the one good thing about Disney is that you can pay it off over time. So what we did for my wedding is I booked it about a year in advance, a little bit over a year, and we paid it off without interest over 12 months and just kind of made little payments here and there whenever we could, and then ultimately we paid it off. Sorry, I should have mentioned this in the beginning, but if I sound a little weird, it's because I'm getting over a cold, and so my nose is like all stuffed up, so I sound a little crazy, like a frog. So, crazy frog. So if you guys are wondering and you didn't watch my last video, that's what's going on. So anyways, basically, first day we got to the port, when you're having like a wedding package, you get to have priority boarding. So they actually had an attendant grab me and my fiance at the time and my family and took us up to like this concierge place, and we got checked in, and the lady actually even walked us up to the boat. But I was looking around because I've been like I said I've stood in a lot of those lines at other cruise lines. It was just so organized. Disney had their own little like building, and it was indoors, which was nice. It had a lot of air conditioning. It was huge. They had Mickey Mouse taking pictures with people to kind of keep them happy, I guess. But the lines seemed so organized, and that's just like being at Disney. Obviously everything's organized. But when you get on the ship, they actually have people standing in a line on each side, kind of like a red carpet, and they go like, oh, the blah 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 family is boarding the ship. It was really cute, and the ship was beautiful. It was like seriously like a whole city on the sea, and I get seasick normally. I get motion sickness a lot, and I only got it like one night, and I think it was because the ship was so big that you really didn't realize that you were on a ship, which is really nice. So we got to our room, or we got to go to our room after about an hour, but they had like a whole buffet set up for you. So they're like, hey, like the rooms aren't ready yet, but we can have you go to the buffet, you can eat, relax, and then like an hour from now, go to your room. So we did that, we went to the room, and then we had our civil ceremony that day. So if you guys are wondering how that works, the civil ceremony is done while you're still in port, because it wouldn't be legal to get married like out in the middle of the sea. You have to be actually at port. So we brought our marriage license with us, and then we went up to get the civil ceremony over with, where we actually had the ceremony at the same place. So a lady came up and married us, and it was really cute. My family was there, and you know, she's like, okay, it's official. So we like had the whole ceremony. We signed the paperwork, and then she mailed the marriage license off for us. So by the time I got back from the cruise, the city I live in had already processed it and sent it back. So that was super nice. I didn't have to like go and mail it when I got back and worry about how long it would take. It was really awesome. So we did that, and they're really cute. Like they're like, they gave us like little pins that was like happily ever after. After we got actually married, they gave us these like, I showed them to you guys in the Disney Cruise Hall, but it says just married, and it has like Ariel and Prince Eric on it, which is super cute. So we had like Mickey and Minnie, like I showed you guys the bridal ears, and he had the groom ears, and everywhere we went, every Disney employee is like, congratulations, congratulations, like people that were on the cruise were like, congratulations, which was really fun, you know, everybody's like a family, and I just, the experience, like everybody's like united by like a love of Disney, or just like a love of their family and their kids, which is really, really cute. The restaurants and dining on a Disney cruise is amazing. So I'm very picky eater. I think I've told you guys, I don't eat fruits and vegetables except for like potatoes, like black beans, and that's pretty much it. I'm just super picky. So half the time when I go on these cruises, they try to make the food too fancy and I'm left with nothing to eat. So in a Disney cruise, you basically go every night, you have your own assigned table, so you pick what time you want to eat, at 5:30 or you want to eat at 8:30, I think, and you have your own assigned table and your own assigned time. So you're not like, wait, if you just want to sit with your husband, you're not like waiting around for a table that seats two people. You don't have to sit with strangers. You sit with your people you're with, or alone if you're just your family. And every night it's a different restaurant. So on the Disney Fantasy, there was the Animators Restaurant, Enchanted Garden, and Royal Court. They all had different themes. And your waitress and co-waiter, they always came with you every night to the different restaurants. So if you like chocolate milk, like you always drink chocolate milk, they would have that waiting for the kids there. So when you got to dinner, your drinks were already there. They already knew what you wanted. They knew, like me, they're like, okay, this has vegetables on it, I can take it off for you. You know, they already knew. It was so nice to always see the same people every single night. And it was nice not to always be in the same restaurant every night, because the menu absolutely always changed every night. And all the foods that I had on the cruise, I thought were delicious. Like, to be honest, normally on cruises, I will go to the fancy dinner and I will try the food, but I won't like it. So I'll eat like 3 bites of everything and be starving by the time I leave, and I'll go up to the buffet and then I'll eat there, like the regular food. But I never had to do that. Like, you didn't need to. The food was good and I never had to go up to the buffet and do that unless I just wanted ice cream or something. But it was amazing. Like, and the different restaurants, my favorite one was the Animators, because they had Crush from Nemo, and he like talked to you. He would like, I don't know, their technology is crazy, so I guess it's somebody behind the screen, I don't know, but they say like, hey little dude in the red hat, like they see the little kids, like, how are you doing today, what'd you do today, oh, I went snorkeling, oh cool, did you see any fish when you went snorkeling, like they respond back to you. It was really, really cool. So probably the dining was like one of the top things. And also the soda is free on a Disney cruise, so I highly recommend bringing like a big Tervis or whatever kind of cup you want to bring. But the cups that they give you, excuse me, to put soda in, they're only like this big. So if you don't have your own cup, then you kind of have to keep going back for refills. So definitely recommend doing that. Also for the adults or people over 21, you can bring your own alcohol on a Disney cruise. So I know a lot of cruise lines don't allow that. My dad brought like a lot of alcohol, and they, you know, they didn't say anything, and it's allowed. Also, if you go out on the islands and you buy alcohol, like a duty free, you can bring it back to your room. You don't have to like have it confiscated. Like, it always seems weird to me when on the other cruise lines they like confiscate it from you. It's like, okay. I mean, I know they make their money off that, but you can bring it back to your room and have it, and it's really nice. The shopping on Disney Cruise is really amazing if you do like Disney, because they have like 4 different stores and you can just walk in between them all, and then when you're done shopping, you can go pay for your stuff. They actually put out new stuff all the time, so like every night, it's bad and good if you like to shop, then like you get kind of sucked into it. But they put out new and different stuff all the whole cruise, so you keep going back to the shops and kind of looking at the new stuff. They had all the Alex and Ani bracelets, or Annie, and there wasn't like 300 people crowded around it, which was nice, so I could actually look at them, and like at the Magic Kingdom, they're all crowded around, so that was really nice. The entertainment on the ship was amazing. Like, if you have kids, the characters are out every night. They have a schedule that they give you, and the characters are all different places, and you can line up and take your picture with them. And they have like the little card where they put it on your like onboard card. They put your photos to that, so you can go and review them. And like, you'll just randomly be walking back to your room, and then like Cinderella will walk by, which is really, really cool. Especially for, even for me, I like to see the characters, and the kids are just like, oh my god. When we got married, we were able to go take pictures with Mickey and Minnie, which was really cute. They didn't like come to the ceremony or anything, but we wore our clothes that night and went around to the different people and took pictures, and it was cool. Like, a couple people have reached out to me on here and on Instagram telling me that they were on the same ship as me and saw me, which is really cute. And that, I mean, the entertainment is just amazing. Like, even the shows, like, they had Aladdin. It was, like, a Broadway show, like, quality. Like, quality is, like, I mean, it's Disney. And a lot of the other shows my parents thought were cheesy because they were, like, mainly characters singing and dancing with actors that are pretending to be kids. But I like it because I like the characters and I like Disney songs. So, but they had adult entertainment. They had like a comedian. They had a guy who was like a guy that sang and danced, and not danced, but he sang and played guitar, and he was really good. They always had adult things to do at night. Like, they had a comedy club. They had like adult game shows, so it wasn't just all for kids. I mean, obviously Disney Cruise has a lot of things for kids, but it's not only for kids, so I don't want you to think that if you're kind of like a parent and wanting to take your kids and feel like there's nothing for you. There's a whole floor for the kids, and you can drop them off there, and they'll take care of them for you all day, and the kids have a lot of fun because they can play with the other kids. So the rooms are really, really nice. I got a balcony room, and it wasn't like a suite or anything, but it had like a couch that could pull out to a bed. I think my room even had bunk beds that could pull down. It had like a queen size bed, and it kind of had like a little sheet so you can separate it if you needed to. It had a bathtub. Like, I couldn't believe that it had a bathtub. I've always been on cruise ships that are like, the shower is like a little square and you can't even move in there, and it's so uncomfortable. This one you can actually move around. It's not a full-size bathtub, but it's, I could sit down in it. It's just I'm kind of tall, so my legs kind of wouldn't fit in there the whole way, but I mean, it's amazing to have that when I'm used to like a little square. And then the bathroom is separated, and then there's like a closet and, you know, the general stuff. But it was really nice. Like, when people at my work looked at the video, or no, pictures that I put online, which are also on my Instagram, they thought I had a suite, which I did not, which is pretty cool. Also, with the wedding kind of stuff, just so you know, they have a wedding coordinator that's assigned to you, and they actually make sure everything's okay all the whole time. They come and get you when you're ready to go get married. They actually coordinate everything, and it doesn't just stop with the wedding. They actually called us several times during the cruise to make sure that we were happy with everything and that we were having a good time. And they would like put surprises in our room every night. They would put like rose petals. They would give us free champagne. They would give us vouchers for like free pictures, like all that kind of stuff. We actually also paid for a photographer, and he was really nice. Like, Michael was late to the ceremony, like a little bit, because he thought it was at 4:30, but it was really at 4, and kind of cut into our photography time because it was only for an hour. But the guy actually stayed with us for over an hour to make sure that we had all the pictures that we wanted. It wasn't rushed at all, which was really nice. And he was also our contact the whole time for the pictures, so he let us like look at them, pick out the ones we wanted printed, make sure we were happy. Like, he was always the one, so that was nice to have somebody assigned to us. The ceremony, they decorated it really pretty, and they had the captain marry us, which was really cool. I didn't realize it was actually going to be the captain, but it was, and he was really nice. And he's like, you guys are going to make me cry. And he was like, you guys are the first ones to ever read vows off your iPad and all that stuff, which is really cute. And we got to take pictures with him, and he signed our marriage certificate, like the one that Disney gives you. He signed it, so that's pretty cool. The cake was really beautiful. We had a cake that had like white chocolate seashells on it, and they actually had it delivered down to dinner for us, so we could actually eat it with our dinner, because it was kind of like we did it for the pictures, but we needed to eat it later, so they did that, which was really nice. They had a lady playing the piano, and she did like Zippity Doodah or whatever other songs we wanted. If you guys haven't watched my video, then go watch it. I have like the ceremony in there, you could hear her playing it. But everybody was really super nice, and we always felt special on the cruise, and I think that's how a lot of people feel. Like, they just go above and beyond to make you feel special. Like I said, on the wedding night, we went to go see Aladdin, and that was like one of my favorite shows, and the guy who plays Aladdin, he came out on this like fake horse, and we were dressed up. Obviously I had my wedding dress. He goes, "Whoa, you look awesome!" And then he went in like to sing the song, which was really cute. And everywhere we went, like, people who worked there, people who were on the cruise, they were super nice to us, congratulated us. On our wedding night, they had free drinks. Disney was just giving out free drinks, like, for, like, 3 hours. And they weren't just, like, tiny drinks. They were, like, free alcoholic beverages. And that was pretty cool, because I've seen where, like, sometimes if you go to those tastings, they might give you a free one. But they were just handing them out for, like, 3 hours straight, and it just unlimited drinks, which is kind of dangerous. But I thought that was amazing. All the different like ports that we went to were also really nice. I think the one that kind of disappointed me was I think it was Grand Turk. There wasn't as much to do as I thought, but Disney did have a lot of excursions. My family is kind of cheap. We didn't want to pay for them. We always feel like, plus we don't like to be scheduled. We hate being scheduled. So we kind of went out and explored on our own. But the thing is, like my mom was pointing out, if we didn't find something to do on the island, we wanted to come back to the ship because there was so much to do and it was so nice that we'd like to do it. So they had like the aqueduct, like for the pool area, they have that ride. It's like a little water slide that goes around the ship, so it kind of seems like you're going to go off the side of the ship, which is crazy. But it was really, really fun. The pools were nice. They have a pool just for adults and they have a pool for the kids. And at the top, they have like your buffet, so they have like 24-hour food there and like unlimited ice cream, and everything is themed to Disney. So like the ice cream thing has Mike Wazowski with like an ice cream cone on his head, which is really cute. Oh, and then some other tips I wanted to mention if you are going on a Disney cruise that I didn't know about. People decorate their stateroom door. They have like magnets, and I'm pretty sure you can buy them on Etsy. There's magnets, and they like make them look like characters, and they have like little whiteboards, and they will ask you like, "Hey, I'm going snorkeling today, what'd you do?" And like when you're walking by, you like write a message to the person, and we like on the kids that were near us, we like always drew like these crazy pictures while they were gone, and they would always come back and be like, "Oh my god, look at this picture." And I just thought it was so cute, and I wish that we had something on our door. I was like, we just got married or something cute. And also a lot of parents had like these, it's almost like stockings, like for around Christmas, but kind of like stockings, but it's like every person who had them, they would make little treat bags, and they would like anonymously put them in your little like stocking, and they would kind of swap around all the different rooms, especially the ones that had kids. I just thought that was really cute. If I knew about that, I would have like made some treat bags, like go to the dollar store and get some little toys and put them in these little kids' bags, because it just like makes their day, and it's really cute. And it just made me like think, like when we're older, not older, well soon, but when we have kids one of these days, to take them and have that type of experience and just be like, "Oh, we're gonna sneak down and put a present in that one." I just thought it was really cute, and it was neat to see all the kids being excited about it. Of course I'm a big kid, so I would be excited too, but I just thought it was really, really cute. So all in all, like my experience getting married on there, getting, you know, having my general cruise, having my like honeymoon on there too, it was just an amazing experience. The wedding was beautiful. We were treated like nothing but gold the whole time, and so was my family. The experience was amazing. Like their private island, I forgot to mention this, but their private island, they actually take you on a tram to the different places like they do at the park. So you're not like trekking it 100 feet to the beach. Like, they have a tram that drops you off. It's all their own island. They have a special island for adults. And I just thought the cruise overall was amazing. And I probably could not even go on another non-Disney cruise because I would just keep comparing it to this one. And my parents agreed too. Like I said, my parents are not Disney people. So for them to say like, oh my god, that was amazing, like I would only go on Disney, that tells you something. So if you guys have any questions at all about Disney cruises or getting married on a Disney cruise or any questions at all that I didn't kind of cover in this video, leave it in the comments below and I will do my best to answer it if I can. If not, I will try to look it up for you. I appreciate you guys watching this video. I hope that one day you guys get to go on a Disney cruise. It is super worth it, and I know it's expensive, but really, like, the memories that you make are really amazing. So thank you guys so much. Please give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. Please subscribe if you're not already. If you are, thank you so much. I think we're only like 6 or 7 away from 500, so we get to do the Disney giveaway soon, which is awesome. Thank you, thank you, thank you, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.